The flowchart represents an algorithm. The algorithm will terminate if negative 1 is entered. Question A says, complete the trace table for the input data. We've been given a flowchart on the left and some input data. We've also been given a table consisting of 4 columns with variable names and outputs. The purpose of a trace table is to trace what the values of the variables are as the program is executed using this input data. In each column, we're going to be tracking how these variables change using this flowchart. There are 2 important rules to follow when completing a trace table. The first rule is that when we get to the start of the loop in the flowchart, we're going to write the changing variables in a new row. The second rule is to only write the values of variables that change. In other words, when the value of a variable changes, we're only going to be writing the value of that variable. Let's now complete this trace table by going through this program outlined in the flowchart. We'll use this input data whenever we see an input block within the flowchart. The first block is always going to be the starting terminal. We'll then follow the arrow to the next block, which we can see is an input block. This tells us that the user must enter a value, and that value is going to be assigned to the variable value. In the trace table, we are tracking the variable value. So we're going to be entering the first data item, which is 50, and we'll update the table with 50. Following the arrow, we get to a decision block. The decision asks, is the value equal to negative 1? The value of this variable is 50 at the moment, which is not equal to negative 1. The answer is no, so it will follow this line to another decision. This decision asks, is the value greater than or equal to 50, and is the value less than or equal to 100? Let's evaluate this decision over here. We have a couple of different paths to this condition. We have the Boolean operator and in the middle. A Boolean operator can only be evaluated with 2 Boolean values on the left and the right. You can see here that we have value greater than or equal to 50 and value less than or equal to 100. These are not single values, so we must evaluate these 2 first. To help visualize what needs to be evaluated first, we can draw brackets around them. Starting off, we have value greater than or equal to 50. This symbol in the middle means that the value can either be greater than 50 or it can be equal to 50. In this case, the value is 50, so this would evaluate to true. Let's evaluate this side. The value is less than or equal to 100. Less than or equal to means that the value can either be less than 100 or equal to 100. We can now evaluate the AND operator, since we have 2 Boolean values on the left and the right. The condition for AND is that both sides need to be true for the entire condition to be true. That is the case, so this entire condition is evaluated to true. Going back to the decision block, that means we would follow the yes arrow, and we get to this process block. This process block says, diff1 is assigned 100 minus value. Diff1 is a variable that we're tracking in the trace table, so we want to work out what 100 minus value is and assign it to that variable. Value is equal to 50, so 100 minus 50 is equal to 50. Let's go ahead and fill in 50 under the diff1 column. We then follow the arrow to the next process block, which is diff2, is assigned value minus 50. Value is 50. Subtract that from 50. And we get 0. This is assigned to the variable diff2. Let's go ahead and fill in 0 under the diff2 column. Again, following the arrow, we get to a decision block. The decision block says, is diff1 less than 1 or diff2 less than 1? Let's go ahead and evaluate this condition down here. Again, we have a Boolean operator. In this case, it is the OR operator, which can only be evaluated with a Boolean on the left and the right. Similar to this condition over here, we'll write brackets around the conditions that need to be evaluated first. The first condition, diff1 is less than 1. The value of diff1 is 50. 50 is not less than 1. This means this part of the condition is evaluated to false. Diff2 less than 1. The value of diff2 is 0. 0 is less than 1. So this part of the condition is evaluated to true. We can now evaluate the OR Boolean operator. The rule for OR is that either side may be true for the entire condition to be true. The right side is true, meaning this entire condition evaluates to true. Going back to the flowchart, this would mean we follow the yes arrow and we get to this output block saying output accept colon extreme. Since we have an output column, we want to write out whatever the output's going to be. So let's go ahead and write out accept colon extreme. We can follow this arrow all the way back to the top of our flowchart and we restart the loop. This rule says that whenever we start the loop, we go to a new row. So when we input the next value, we're going to write that value in the next row. In this case, we're repeating the input block where we're inputting a new value for the variable value. The next one from our input data is 75. So 75 is assigned to the variable value. We can show this in our trace table by writing 75 underneath the value column. Now we're just repeating what we've done previously, so we can go through it a bit quicker. Following the arrow, we have a decision block asking, is the value equal to 1? The value is not equal to 1 yet, so we follow the no line. And again, we'll evaluate this condition. Value is now 75, so we can quickly evaluate this condition. This side would be true, since 75 is greater than 50. And the right side would be true as well, since value is less than 100. This means the entire condition is true, since we have an AND operator. So we'll follow the yes line, and again, we're going to be doing these two processes. The value of diff1 is going to be 100 minus value, which is 100 minus 75. This gives us an answer of 25. 25 is assigned to diff1. Let's fill this out. We then have diff2, which is value minus 50. So 75 minus 50 gives us a result of 25. And we'll write 25 underneath the diff2 column. The next decision block, again, we have this condition. Let's evaluate this. The value of diff1 is now 25, which is not less than 1. So this would evaluate to false. And the value of diff2 is also not less than 1. It is 25. So this would also evaluate now to false. Since both sides of the OR operator are false, so now we'd follow the no arrow. We get to this output statement, which says accept colon normal. So under the output column, we'll write down accept colon normal. Following this arrow, we go back to the beginning of our flowchart and we restart this process. The next value to input is going to be 99. Let's go through this a bit quicker now. This value is not equal to minus 1, so we continue. We can evaluate this condition. You should notice that all this condition is doing is checking if the value is between 50 and 100. Including both 50 and 100. If it is between these two, then we follow the yes line. If it is not between the two, then we would follow the no line. Here we have 99, which is between these two. So we'd follow the yes line and we'd execute these two processes. Diff1, we're going to assign to 100 minus 99. That's going to give us a 1. So we'll write that underneath the diff1 column. Diff2, we're going to be assigning to 99. Minus 50, that is going to give us 49, which we'll write in the diff2 column, and we can evaluate this condition. What you should notice about this condition now is that it's going to be true when either diff1 or diff2 is less than 1. In this case, neither variables fulfill the condition, so we'd follow the no line and we'd write down accept normal underneath the output column. Going back to the beginning, we input the next value, which is going to be 28. 28 is not between 50 and 100, so now we follow the no line, and we output reject colon abnormal. We now go back to the beginning of the loop, and we input the next value, which is going to be 82. The value is still not equal to minus 1, so we continue, and we evaluate this condition. 82 is between 50 and 100, so we're now executing these two processes. Diff1 is going to be set to 100. Minus 82, which is equivalent to 18. So we write 18 underneath the diff1 column. One thing to notice is that I've skipped this row. The reason is because of this rule, in that the start of the loop means that we are only writing changes to variables on a new row. Diff1 and diff2 were not modified on the previous loop, but they will be modified in this loop, so we want to write them on the same row to not cause any confusion. Diff2 is set to 82 minus 50, which results in 32. Let's write that under the diff2 column, again remembering to skip this row. Going to this condition, neither diff1 nor diff2 are less than 1, so we'll output accept normal. The next item to enter is 150. This is not equal to minus 1, so again we continue to the condition. 150 is not between 50 and 100, so we'd follow the no line and we'd output reject abnormal. The next item to enter is minus 1. This condition is now true since value is equal to minus 1. This means we follow to the end and we would stop there. Even though there are two more items to enter, we do not enter them in the trace table since we have ended the flowchart. If you do write these in, you would lose a mark for this question. But there we go, that is this question completed.